I think what's happened is everyone's in this modern day and age, we've kind of tailored the religion to our own needs. Yeah? Because we don't, obviously, as Muslims, we're not trying to be like that. But we're trying to lead a good example, you see. So,
my friend, how you can be the good example of anything if your prophet is the worst example of mankind? With my respect to you, I'm not trying to insult you, but I'm saying to you what I believe.
You're not insulting me.
Yeah. So if I am a Muslim and you are a Muslim, how Islam can be the best example for us if the Prophet himself is a rapist? If the best example for us, he married children. Do you like to marry children, Adam? Do you like to marry children?
No.
Do you like to have a wife? She is 6 years old. Like, okay, what is the best example on that? What Muhammad is teaching us when he is 54 years old, marrying a child, she is 6 years old.
He's not really teaching us anything, to be honest with you.
He's teaching us fifth. He's teaching us to be perverted people. He's teaching us not to be right. And remember, when I say things, I don't mean to insult. Please don't think I'm insulting you. Okay. Imagine a guy at the age of 54 come to ask for your sister and she is 6 years old. What you would do to him?
I may kill him.
So how you accept Muhammad to be a prophet? Now, you as a Muslim, me as a Christian, we spoke together already. And you had the opportunity for somebody who is a Christian to clear things out to you. So now you are out of excuse to say, oh, nobody told me.
That's true.
So there is no way to say, here we go. We are talking with you for the last half hour or more. And you agree with me in many, many points. So based on the agreement, you know, we agree, we share the ground in many things together. So shouldn't we make a decision based on what we got? If you got the idea that Muhammad cannot be a prophet of God, he do evil stuff, it's obvious everything he stands for is false. Imagine I want to speak to you about morality, but I don't have it. I'll give you a speech about morality, but me myself, I don't have it. The one who don't have it, he cannot give it. In order for me to speak to you about holiness, I have to be holy myself.
Yes.
In order to speak to you, give you a lecture about honor, I have to be a person of honor. Muhammad is not a person of honor. Do you know the story of Muhammad going to his own son and he flirt with his wife?
No, I don't.
Imagine my dad come to my house while I am not there and then he flirt with my wife. What kind of a father this father is? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So Muhammad, to be a person who want to teach me about God, shouldn't he first ask himself how to teach himself a small good manner, that if you go to your son's house, you should not do this? Not only a son. Let us say I am a person who claim to be a Christian. Then I go to your house and I flirt with your wife, with my respect to her. What kind of a Christian I am? I invite you right now to denounce Islam, to reject Islam. And if you have a question for me about Christianity more, I will be happy to answer you, my friend. I will be happy to hear from a smart person like you, who is born of a Muslim family, to accept that Muhammad no way can be a prophet, and that it will be the good start for you to be a new person. And then we can search, maybe the Messiah is true, maybe he's not. You know, instead you have to make decisions. But you just admit it and you just agree that Muhammad can't be a prophet. You did not say it clearly, but you did say that, you said that already. I don't know if you saw the hadith I was showing you, that your prophet, he said that when you go to heaven, Allah will make your penis will never sleep. Do you see a hadith in front of you on screen, my friend?
I don't, but I'm following you.
Okay, it says, Muhammad taking an oath saying, there's no one whom Allah admit to paradise, but Allah will marry him to 72 wives, 2 from the houris and 70 from the inheritance from the people of hell, all of whom have desirable front passages, which mean Muhammad, Allah even describing for us that those women are specially imported from hell. Do you know what does that mean? What do you think about why those women, Allah will take them from hell? Why they are coming from hell?
Because they're the dirtiest.
Because they are what?
The dirtiest.
Because they are hookers. They are expert. Yeah. They are expert in sex. So Allah will choose for you from the warehouse of hell the best of the hookers who they are very good in all the skills of sex. We do not want to give details. And now he described to us that they are very beautiful to the point you will be crazy when you see their boobs and their vagina. Excuse my language.
No, it's
what
fine.
Kind of a prophet he said that? And look what he continues saying. And he will have a male member which will never become flaccid, i.e. soft limp. How this is can be a prophet of God speaking to me about heaven of God, saying to me, don't worry, be happy. Allah will provide you with penis, will never go sleep because it's made from concrete. And the women, Allah will go to the warehouse of hell and he will import for you the best women in sex from hellfire. Denounce this garbage, man. This is not for you. You are smarter than this. You are honorable man. You cannot be a person who belong to this.
So where do I belong?
Do you want to belong to Muhammad after what you heard?
Yeah, but I can't say to you them words and then go to my community and pretend like I never said this.
We'll say it. You want to go to the community, you say to them, you want to be a hypocrite?
I don't want to be a hypocrite either.
So? You are worried about your community, but you are not worried about your honor. You wanna fool yourself, says this. So you are saying to me, okay, I agree with you. Muhammad is a false prophet. Obviously, this is devilish, cannot be from God. But because I have a community and I have to make them happy with me, I'm not going to say that.
Yeah.
But that means I accept with my respect to you to be a hypocrite.
Yeah.
So now you believe that Muhammad is not a prophet, but yet you want to say to them Muhammad is a prophet just because you don't want to make them sad. But that, you know, you will respect yourself. It's up to you. You know. So denounce Muhammad, say be a man, and I'm sure you are the man. Denounce him and say, Muhammad can't be a prophet. There is no way I'm going to follow such a man.
Okay. Muhammad cannot be a prophet. I accept that. Yeah.
I mean to that. Wonderful. I'm so happy for you, my friend Muhammad, or Adam, sorry. And, you know, I'm happy for you that you make a decision. I want you to step back and think about what is next. What is the best to follow? Maybe nothing is best to follow. Maybe stay an atheist. Or maybe the Messiah, who's no name like him, and no name better than him. He never say false, he never speak sin, he never do sin. The one who is above the heaven and the earth, the one who did miracles, which is amazing. The one who said something nobody can say, love your enemy. So I am inviting you right now to accept my Lord, the Messiah, to be your savior. I'm not forcing you to accept it, because in Christianity, you have to be reborn again. There's nothing is called born of a Christian family. We don't believe in that. You have to be reborn again with the Christ, which means you have to make a decision of your own. That I am Adam, who was a Muslim, and now I denounce the devil. I want to accept the Messiah as my Savior, as my personal God. That is a personal choice you make, not something you inherit. We are not Muslim. We don't believe in that. So if you want to accept the Messiah, I invite you right now. I have the honor to present to you the best name of the good God, which his name is amazing. His name is the Messiah. If you like to accept him, feel free to say, I accept.
I accept.
Amazing. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Today, my friend Adam, there is a happiness in the heaven. The Bible says, when one person is saved, there is a happiness in the kingdom of God. Imagine how much loving God he is. While Muhammad is busy killing, chopping heads, killing people just to please his God, our God said that the happiness will be in the heaven of God just because you, Adam, now, you accept him. So my friend Adam, I'm so happy to have you today as my guest. I believe that the Lord, he sent you in my way, and the Lord, he sent me in your way. So me and you, we can witness for him. And the Lord, the Messiah, he said, every two of you say my name, I will be the third. Jesus right now is with us. He heard you. He heard me. And today, from today, you are a child of God.